Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the INDATA Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. Look at this beautiful day. We are so excited to be doing an adaptive vehicle expo here at Easter Seals Crossroads. This is not your typical tech tip. The tent behind me is where we have some of the most cutting-edge adaptive vehicles for people with disabilities to be found, the first time all gathered together here in the state of Indiana. So we're going to spend a little time going and checking out some of these vehicles, meeting some of the drivers, and learning about the state of the art when it comes to adaptive driving. So let's go check this out.
Right. My name is Brandon Scott, and I'm going to show you the process I go through to get my vehicle started and running. First, what I do is I have to take off my shoe in order to be able to control one of my joysticks. And then I have a slingback on my wheelchair joystick, so that way I'm able to pull into the driver's slot and keep everything out of the way. I utilize the easy lock system. I have a pin that goes on the bottom of my wheelchair that locks myself into the floor, so that way my wheelchair will not move around. And then to get the vehicle started, I actually have a blue button that I hit over on the touch screen to wake up the computer to get the vehicle started. And then at this point, the computer goes through a diagnostic check. It makes sure that all the steering and the accelerator and brake components are all hooked up properly. So it goes through a functions testing on the touchscreen. Once it does its testing, I do have to initiate the systems. Where I first start off, I have to push forward for the accelerator, pull back for the brake, and then I do a steering test just to the left and then to the right. And at this point now, the vehicle is all set and ready to run. On my touchscreen, I have the capabilities to be able to put the vehicle into park, reverse, drive. I can use the windows, windshield wipers, two different levels for the windshield wipers. I'm also able to utilize cruise control, which I never do, but I have the capability for that. I can lock and unlock the vehicle. There is also ways to run the defroster from this, but I find it easier for myself just to reach with my toe to the controls that come with the vehicle. On this vehicle, it's also equipped with a backup camera, so when I'm backing up, I do not have to turn all the way around. I'm able to just look into a screen that I have on the center console, and it shows me what's behind me. That actually came standard with the van itself. I do have the steering system, a joystick for my left arm that I can steer with. And then down by my right foot, I grasp a joystick that I can push forward for the accelerator and I pull back for the brake. If I pull back too far on the brake, it engages the emergency brake. To turn the vehicle off, I just hit the stop button. And then I have to hit another button that just turns off the rest of the controls for the vehicle. So then the vehicle is completely shut off, at which point I can unlatch myself from my easy lock. And then I'm ready to go wherever I pull up at.
So how cool was that, right? All kinds of adaptive vehicles, the state of the art for what's happening in adaptive driving. So that's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the INDATA Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.